Namaste guys, in this video I will tell you how to show weld bead in SolidWorks. So first of all, what I need to do is create a geometry. So I am just creating a geometry. Click OK and extrude it and select the top plane. Remember, I'm just making a geometry. After that I will show you how to show the weld bead. After that, go to weldments, click on structural membrane. I have already selected ISO square tube 30x30 2.6. click OK. Now after that, click on weld bead. Here you see options like weld geometry, weld path. So a question arises, when there is need to use weld geometry and when there is need to use weld path. So here click on weld path. So weld path is basically used when you have basically edges. As you can see here, you can simply select the edges and create the weldment. These edges is basically gives the path. Now after that, enter the weld bead area or bead size. Okay, click OK. As you can see, there is no weld bead here. Now to look into that, just click on view, click on view weld beads. As you can see here, I am able to see it. And a question arises in your mind, so where is weld geometry used? Weld geometry is used when, for example, when it is difficult to define path. At that scenario you use weld geometry. Now press Ctrl plus Z. Now click on weld bead again. Now click on here. Now go to from to length. Now I will tell you how what is the purpose of from to length. For example, you don't want that this full line is weld, you just want some little distance. So you can control them by just moving or dragging the arrows as per the requirement. Here you can see, or you can just adjust the length here by changing the length as per your requirement. Click OK. Here you see, it's a small weld. So basically it is used when you want to use less weld bead because there is no requirement. Remember, if you use full weld bead but there is no requirement, it means you are just wasting your money, energy, time and labor cost. So don't do that. Only use weld bead as per the requirement. Why? It doesn't make sense wasting money or, you know, time, etc. Now let's see another thing, gusset. So gusset is basically a triangular shape. You can enter the dimensions here as per the requirement, and here you see edge, mid, side. So this is just what do, and you can change the thickness as per your requirement. Okay, click OK. Now click on weld bead. Click on weld geometry. Here you can see what is mean by weld geometry. Click here and here. Here you can see that it automatically detects the path and create the weld bead here. So this is where we use weld bead, and you can change the length as per the requirement. For example, you don't want the length to this much. So here you can see that I can control the weld as per my requirement. Here click on intermittent. It means that you want a distance in between them. You don't want it in continuous manner. So at that moment you use intermittent weld. And if you want pitch, as we know what is pitch, weld length, and pitch is 3 mm, it means that the after 3 mm there is a weld bead of 2.5 mm. You can change it as per your requirement. Okay, I hope it fully helps you how to use weld bead of and where and when to use. If you have any doubts and queries, make sure you ask in comments, and make sure you check out our video in comments, video in description, that how to calculate the size of this weld bead in your simulation. For example, do you really need this much of weld bead, or do you need less, and what is the weld bead radius? So if you want to know how to calculate in SolidWorks, then check out the our other video that is in the link in description. Thanks for watching and have a great day. Namaste.